Please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
We have to look at the market impact of what has been a terrible tragedy. Almost 2 weeks of incessant downpour and a resulting flood situation in Kerala to take stock of how this could impact some of the Kerala-based NBFC companies. George Alexander Muthoot, Managing Director of Muthoot Finance, joins us now on the phone line. Good morning, George. Thank you very much for joining us. All our commiserations for what must have been a very trying time. Before we get to the numbers itself, are things limping back to normalcy? Would you say the worst of the flood is behind you at Kochi, at Pattanamthitta, at all the affected areas?
Yeah, thank you. And I think overall, we have lost more than 200 lives, but thousands of houses have been affected by this, and which will require a lot of huge repairs, especially to shops, houses, business, etc. But the whole state has been actually acting as one. All the people, even the fisher folk from other places came with boats. The Navy came, the Army came, Air Force came. Everything worked. Everybody worked as a team. So probably we were able to restrict the lives lost. But property damage definitely is there. To answer your question about receding, the water has started receding, but still the catchment areas of the bad. We have so many dams here, about around 40 dams here. So some of those dams have to be opened now also. So that is what is happening now also. So all the dams are on full capacity. So if they start opening, a little affect the water level may rise more. But okay. Then effectively it is definitely under control. And things are looking back, looking to get normal.
So, George, therefore, to come to your own P&L and your own immediate business, have you all taken stock, any preliminary stock, prima facie, do you think that there can be defaults, more than usual defaults this quarter?
See, as you are aware, our business is mainly focused on gold loans only. And even in gold loans, only less than 5% or 4 to 5% of our business comes from Kerala, because Kerala is generally seen by us as a resource mobilization state and not as a lending state. So Kerala, although we started in Kerala, our business, gold loan business, less than 5% is from Kerala. But as far as the impact of the branch on the branches are concerned, only 3 of our branches which were on the ground floor have been affected due to this flood. So what happens is the gold is stored in the strong room or in the safe. It is actually safe. It only gets wet. We don't lose it. But the documents, etc., we will have a difficulty in retrieving the documents. But of course, because of the core banking systems, it may not be a big difficulty. So out of that, only 3 branches have been affected, but staff are unable to come to the branch. That's the actual fact of it. And roads and connectivity, etc. But some of the staff personally would have lost a lot of some possessions, their houses, etc. As far as the business is concerned, gold loan business, very, very minimal impact, I should say.
Okay, so minimal impact, less than 4 to 5% comes from Kerala and 3 branches have been affected. George, hi, morning. For the industry, though, what kind of impact do you see? I mean, in general, what percentage of loans comes from the Kerala market and what kind of long-term damage do you see or ramifications do you see for the industry?
Yeah, but banks and the people who have lent money to MSMEs or to the other sectors of small shopkeepers, etc., because the shopkeepers' business have been affected, it will have certainly an impact on their repayment, because most of them would be secured with the stocks, etc., and I'm not sure how many of them are being fully insured on these stocks, etc. So the shopkeepers would be affected, and the people also would be affected in their business as well as their salaries, etc. Of these shop workers in the shops.
But George, you know, as it is, y'all were seeing a rise in your NPAs. Will not this add to the pressure at all for you, and even loan growth?
See, I told you the business growth in Kerala is stagnant for the last 3 years. Actually, it has only been coming down. only less than 5%, I told you, of the business comes from Kerala. So Kerala, even otherwise, has not been impacting our balance sheet or our top-line growth or our income, etc. As far as the NPAs are concerned, we have always told you that since we have the gold with us, the NPAs is just a technical NPA, and we are fully secured with the gold always with us. So I don't think there is an impact on that on the P&L.